have cooking now.
All right, everybody loves waffles. And yes, whether you're cooking at home or whether you're cooking at the campsite, waffles are always a hit.
Yes, they are.
Especially with the kids. So let me show you what we're gonna do. Now, inside here, I've got that silicone waffle mold. And I've already got the heat on, so this is getting heated up. This is made, of course, silicone bakeware. Has been used for a long, long time. It's really nice, it's naturally non-stick. You don't have to butter this or use any Crisco or anything inside there. So, but what I'm gonna do here is do a few different types. Now, I like to start with the berries down. I'm gonna do some blueberries first.
And this is so ideal for picky kids and families who want all different flavors, because you can put a different flavor in each mold, can't you?
That's right. And if you wanna, you know, do some chocolate chips maybe for the kids
for
or for the big kids like you. Or, and how about just some chopped nuts, some pecan nuts.
Perfect.
Yeah. Pecan, where you're from.
Okay. Pecan.
So I'm gonna start with those now.
Tomato.
Uh-huh. And then here, I'm just gonna use some of our batter here, okay? And I mean, you don't wanna fill this all the way to the top. Remember, this is gonna rise, so just give it about half full.
And I really like this way of doing it with all the different flavors as well, because I get a bit of FOMO. I have fear of missing out. And so if I see somebody trying something that I really want, this is just perfect, because I get a little bit of each flavor now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's just go around. And you can always, remember, you can always add more. It's harder to pull away, so. Just do it like so, let that fill in. Okay. I'm gonna do this side here for the pecans. Pecans.
Pecan.
Pecan. Pecan nuts. There we go. Okay. And then here. Okay. Let me just fill that one up. Maybe a little bit more on this guy here. Okay. Just so that the mold is sort of all the way full here. Okay. And just kind of over here. Okay. That one looks pretty good and full there.
Okay, that looks divine.
All right, now all we're gonna do, and I've got that heat up, I'm just gonna close this and let the Quicky pan do all the work.
Perfect, and so in the meantime, we've got my heat on, so we're going to just do the little frozen version to just show you how easy it is to make frozen waffles as well. So we've got some that I've already prepared earlier. Put them right in.
Those are mostly frozen, right? I mean, they look like they've defrosted a little bit being out here, but they're still sort of frozen inside, yeah.
And we're doing the healthy version, no oil, no butter, just straight into the pan. Close that, and that's going to be ready in a few minutes.
Right.
I mean, who really heard of cooking waffles out camping?
Exactly. You can't exactly take a waffle maker out into the forest with you, or who knows where you're hiking, in the jungle maybe.
That is not a typical move, but now because of glamping, we want to make sure that we're having top of the line breakfasts while we're out. We need to impress our friends.
That's right. And so here you can do waffles. I mean, out on the range, we're using a gas stove to cook waffles.
And we need to be able to take Instagram-worthy breakfast photos, so this is kind of perfect. If you're a big Instagrammer like me, you need a Quicky pan to take amazing pictures of your food.
You take pictures of all your food.
I take pictures of everything, just full stop.
That's right.
But now I can take pictures of my food while I'm camping. Here you go.
There you go. All right, and again, waffles in the pan. And it's really the only pan I've seen that you can bake on the stovetop. Normally, you always
Never
need an oven. You need an oven. It has to go in. That's just the nature of baking. This way, because it's encapsulated, because all that heat stays inside here, the heat's not just coming off the top. The moisture isn't being cooked out of it. It's literally baking inside of a pan. Isn't that
unheard
cool?
of? Absolutely unheard
right.
of.
And you're about ready to flip it over.
Yep, I can smell that's ready, so I'm going to flip her over.
There you go. And again, you're crisping on one side, you're cooking it evenly through the middle. That's frozen to fabulous in 4 minutes.
Frozen to fabulous in 4 minutes.
Frozen to fabulous in 4 minutes. Try saying that fast 4 times.
Frozen to fabulous in four minutes.
All right, take a look. These are about ready to flip. See how they are there? You can already see those blueberries bubbling through. That is going to be
so tasty.
So good. Okay, I'm going to just lock the handle and then do a quick flip.
Flip it.
And let those finish
good.
Up there. And then let's see. You want to flip it over and see how yours came out? All right. And look.
Wow, perfection.
Nice.
Gorgeous.
Frozen waffles. Look at that. It's just got a nice little brownness on the outside. Perfect.
Nice and crispy.
Perfection. Here, you want to plate those? You're
nice
about ready?
Nice and crispy. Yes.
All right. And then while you're plating those, here.
So if you're looking for convenience, you can start with some really easy frozen waffles. But if you want the creme de la creme, let's check out Jeremy's waffles. With a little bit more time, you can make your own while you're camping as well.
Right, here it is. And again, I used that silicone mold right here. Let me just open this up and see how those came. Oh!
Holy
how
moly.
Awesome is that right there?
I can't believe that you made these.
Yep, made those from scratch. And you know, here, let me just kind of
look at those
this.
Blueberries.
Blueberries, just nice. Look at that.
This is definitely Insta-worthy right here.
Blueberry waffles here. There's my pecan waffle. There's my chocolate chip waffles. Oh my gosh, it's so good. And then I'm just gonna, here, let's just smother it all.
Wow.
In some of our,
okay, even
syrup.
Even the most stubborn people who don't wanna go camping, after you show them this, they will be all about it.
That's right. And so whether you're cooking from scratch or you're cooking from frozen, you're gonna use your Quicky pan whenever you need to cook something, whether you're camping or at home or in a park. Just the Quicky pan outdoor cooking system is perfect. I'm gonna go in for a blueberry. Look at that.
This looks like a piece of art. Look at the colors in
that. It is so good. I mean, look at that. Just like the blueberry like melts like it's a piece of chocolate now.
Wow. Are you having a foodgasm? Yeah, in case you can't hear, he's having a foodgasm right now.
All thanks to the Quicky pan.
I love a good Quicky foodgasm.